Welcome back to the series of 21 days, 21 tips. So where we are discussing some tips that testers have given based on their experience, which have helped them, and they will help you for sure. So there are 400 plus tips from 140 testers. So, and today's topic is assumptions. So what comes to your mind when you think about assumptions as a tester? So let's begin. So this is how some testers, or most of them, defines like this. And you may define in a different way, that it's a mother of all failures, and assumptions are like sin. The Hindi word is pap. For testers, like, you should never assume. Sometimes in interview, sometimes getting requirement and discussion things. For example, if someone says you to test Gmail, right? So maybe you can start directly giving them scenarios, but you can ask things like, maybe the person wants you to test only on mobile, or only on a particular type of maybe Android or iPhone, or maybe an online app. So we should not have assumptions, because it could cause problem. And if you are assuming anything, then maybe you can confirm it what you want, because that way you can reduce scope. Okay, or you could increase scope based on the questions that you ask. And if you're assuming anything, you can document it. So later on, if someone asks you a question that why you did not cover that, or why you are covering this, you have stated your assumption and it has been confirmed. Like, nothing on oral things, like sometimes in meetings, people confirm, but get it documented. That will help you. And you can have conversations. So there are two ways that are suggested, like you can have conversation. So not good one be, like, if you are trying to get an answer in yes or no, right? So better to get a more detailed answer. For example, you might ask that, how come we don't have a mobile app, right? Instead of asking, is it a mobile site? Like, for example, you have to test the mobile site also or not. So that answer could be yes or no. So you can have detailed questions, smart questions, I would say. So how to deal with assumptions? You can challenge them, right? You can ask them whether it could be according to requirement as well, right? For example, if you are testing something related to a phone number. So it might not be the case that everybody has a 10-digit phone number, right? It could be maybe consider that they want you to consider landline numbers as well, right? So that's one example. And you can reevaluate your assumptions if you have taken in the starting of some testing or project, and then later you realize, and also test the assumptions of others. So if maybe others have assumed something and they are going on ahead, so you can test those things. Ask questions. Yeah, it might look stupid. It's fine. But you will have more clarity by asking questions. Then it might no longer remain in assumptions if a person has confirmed it. Right, even if they appear obvious, it's fine, because it's a sin, as you have seen, and it is a mother of all failures, right? So instead of causing a failure, there is no problem in asking a question. And when you don't ask it, right, so you suffer from this lack of asking them, right? And more questions will invite answers, and it will clear your understanding. And as we discussed earlier, that you can ask smart questions. So this is what about in 21 days, 21 tips about assumptions. Here is this mind map, and the details I'll share in the description, and you'll find it on my blog. And you can subscribe to this channel, and easy way to remember is linktree/GauravKhurana, which will land you here. And then you can check it out. And the easy way to bit.ly/testing_tips. Thanks for watching. Happy testing.